It keeps me whole to think about tomorrow, to think about the future, to think about tomorrow. God is good.
Yes.
You know, I feel tears of joy when Mama Pastor was speaking about these things. You know, God is faithful. When I met with my wife, in my mind, I said, we're gonna be missionaries in Africa. I say we're gonna live in Africa. We're gonna stay in Africa doing missions. Doing missions. And during that time in Tanzania, we sat down after having a very powerful day in a meeting. Then we had to have dinner together at the table. Then I went out of my room because we were to meet at the table having dinner. Then I could see Mama Pastor like clicking around. It's like they have talked about something that they want to tell me. Then I heard them telling me that, okay, tomorrow, it's you and Sarah, you are going to preach. So the following day in the morning, now we were sitting, me and Sarah, preparing the preachings together at the table. Something was just making me feel happy to see that I'm sitting with Sarah. We are preparing for a message to preach that evening. And when we went to preach in the evening, then we agreed, Sarah, who's going to start? Is it you or me? She said, no, let me start. Then she started, she preached. When she was preaching, in my heart I was saying, wow, God, if I could really have such a wife who's preaching. Wow. So she can not only sing, but also preaching. Wow. Then when I stood up, it was my turn. Then when I was preaching, she was also feeling the same thing. So it was wonderful, you know, God can arrange things. You can plan your own way, but God has a different plan for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Reason why I can say I love God, because he pushed me to Norway. I tried to resist. I told her, that country of yours, it's very cold there. But let me come and see first. Then I will decide. But at the last minute, she's telling me, you have to take all your clothes. All your belonging. Then I was saying, now I'm going to see the country. And come back. How come can I take everything? Now when I came, you know, that day it was a very special day for us. Sarah, she was well prepared in the morning. That morning, she prepared everything. She had to drive to Oslo. I will arrive at 10 in the evening, but already at 8, she's driving to Oslo in the morning. Then it was so wonderful. We met in the evening when I arrived. Me, I was planning, okay, oh, it's very cold. Yeah, I've seen it now. But despite of that cold, today I'm just still there. I've never gone back. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, I love God so much.
Yes.
Every time you make a decision to love someone, you put yourself in a situation of pain and suffering. Because the one that you most love, they don't only bring joy to your heart, but sometimes they can bring pain. Why am I saying this? Because it's only God that will never deceive us. It's only God. Once he promised you something, he will come to fulfill it. And today, church, I have a good news for you. Are you there, church? Can you wave your hand? Today, I've got a good news for you. It's not just any other news, but a good news. Tell your neighbor there is a good news in the house today. There is a good news in the house today. Hallelujah. Stand up on your feet and turn to your neighbor. There is a good news today. Shake his hand and tell him, there is a good news today. There is a good news today. Clap your hands together for the King of Kings. Because there is a good news today. Hallelujah. Have your seats. Have your seats. Have your seats. Hallelujah. You know. You know. There is a good news. There is a good news. You know the good news is about the commanding general of the heavenly army is recruiting some people today. He needs some people today. He need you, he need me. He needs some women and men that will stand and say, yes, Lord, here I am. Hallelujah. The commander general of the heavenly army needs some warriors.
Yes.
He needs some soldiers today. I hope today you're gonna stand on your feet and ready to push the work of the enemy. You're gonna push everything that was standing on your way during your life. Today it's a pushing day. I want you to stand with me. There are so many things happened into your life that you are not able to command by the power of God. But today you are going to push. Everybody say push. Push. Don't push, breathe. Something strange can happen. Don't push, breathe. But push the enemy. I made it this way. What does push means? It stands for something. P stands for pray. You stand for until. S stand for something. Hush stand for happening. Now say it. Pray until something happens. We're gonna push.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Wave your hands, church. Today you are going to push until something happens into your life. Amen.
Amen.
I'm taking you into the book of Judges. If you have your Bible with you, I would like you to open in the book of Judges, chapter 6. Verse 11 to 12. Judges chapter 6, verse 11 to 12. Can you read in Norsk?
Herrens engel kom og satte seg under terebintetreet i kraft. Det som tilhørte Abiezeritten, Joash, hans sønn Gideon, tresket hvete i vinpressen for å gjemme dem for midianittene. Herrens engel viste seg for ham og sa til ham, Herren med deg, du mektige kriger.
Halleluja! Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who can read for us in English?
Can you read for us in English?
In English.
11 and 12.
11 and 12.
Now the angel of the Lord came and sat under the terebinth tree which was in Ophrah, which belonged to Joash, the Abiezrite.
Mm-hmm.
While his son Gideon threshed wheat in the winepress in order to hide it from the Midianites. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, the Lord is with you.
Hallelujah.
Mighty man of valor.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The title of my message this morning, I'm going to speak about from nobody to somebody. Everybody say from nobody to somebody. 1, 2, 3.
From nobody.
Uh-huh.
Somebody.
From
nobody
to
somebody.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, this verse is talking about affirmer.
Du vet, denne skriftstedet snakker om en bonde.
And this man enjoyed so much what he's been doing as a farmer. Hallelujah. And this man did not have any desire than just to be a farmer. He never had any thought of a political ambitions. Or he never dreamed about becoming a military leader. He never dreamed anything apart from just being a farmer. But yet, God had a different plan for that person. It's about Gideon. Hallelujah. It's about Gideon. I would like us also to read also down in verse 14. The same chapter. Verse 14. Can you read, please? Hallelujah. The story of this man Gideon, in the Old Testament, it's a very unique story. It's giving us a revelation and how God can make a nobody to become a somebody. Hallelujah. You know, the Bible says the angels appeared while Gideon was threshing wheat in a wine press. He was busy doing his job as a farmer. And the angels appeared. Hallelujah. The angels appeared. Now, what he's been doing? The Bible says he was inside a wine press. Threshing wheat. Busy doing his own business as a farmer. Why he was doing that? Indos, I want us to know the reason why he's been doing that. Before previous on the years and years to come, the Bible says the children of Israel have gone through hard time for 7 years. Every time they will plant their crops, at the moment of the harvest, the enemy will come and destroy everything they had planted. Next year they will plant again. The same things will happen. The enemy will come and destroy and take everything. I'm here to tell you, brothers and sisters, these are the things that can happen or have been happening into your life. You have been planting. You have planted love. You have planted joy. You have planted businesses. When it comes to the harvest time, what you receive is just deception. Because the devil is the enemy is coming to take everything you are planting. Reason why today I'm telling you, it is a day of pushing what the enemy is trying to destroy. Church, today it's a day of pushing. Everything that we've been planting, we want to collect them back. We want our plant, our crops to grow. Not to be destroyed by the enemy. Not to be taken away by the enemy. Hallelujah. The enemy will come and destroy everything. Everything. Hallelujah. So today it's a day that we want to challenge. We want to challenge. Amen. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 10 verse 10. John chapter 10 verse 10. It says thieves does not come except to steal. And to kill and to destroy. Hear what God says. I have come that they may have life and they may have it abundantly. Hallelujah. One thing that you have to know into your life is you are not fighting against the blood and flesh, but you are fighting against every principalities and ruler of this world. But today God gave me this message to put into your mind that you have the authority. Amen. To stop the enemy from destroying your crops. To stop the enemy from destroying your joy. To stop the enemy from destroying your peace. To stop the enemy from destroying your blessings. And today God wants it to happen today. The Bible says the angels appeared. Hallelujah. What does it say? And the angels of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, the Lord is with you, you mighty man. You mighty man. The angels appeared. They told Gideon, the Lord is with you. Gideon, this man Gideon, he didn't have an appearance of a mood of being a strong man by nature. Hear what he answered. He said, how can God use me to go and deliver Israel from the enemy? Number one, I am from a tribe that's the Manasseh. It's just a tribe that has a very low standard. Number two, I'm the smallest in my family. Really, God, can you use me? Some other people, they have made up their mind that, oh, me, I'm just like that. The Lord cannot use me. Hallelujah. Yeah. Today I'm challenging your church. There you are seated. It's a day for you to know that God is with you. You are going to use your authority to push the enemy. Hallelujah. Can you wave your hand? Are you happy about this?
Yes.
Am I giving you something?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So it's not just a story of a great exploit. D This story of Gideon, it's a story that brings transformations into our lives. From nobody to somebody. Gideon tried to ask God so many questions and making God into a lot of process so that he believes that it's you, God, who has come and told me to go. In everything, Gideon had 100% confidence that it's God who's sending me to deliver the children of Israel against the enemy. Hallelujah. The Bible says that Gideon took almost 32,000 people. He collected the people. Amen. Those were the people that were going to face the enemy. Then God told him, "No, Gideon, my son. I think the people are too many." Hallelujah. The people are too many. I want you to take away some of the people. And Gideon used a spiritual strategy. Asking who is scared to go and face the enemy. 22,000. They were being sent home. He remained with 10,000. Hallelujah. Days were moving. God tell again Gideon. Gideon, I think people are still too many. This was now, it was becoming a worry to Gideon. You know, God had a purpose behind it. God did not want the children of Israel to have that big number. When they would have challenged the enemy, they would have maybe started bragging about themselves. It's us, we have won the enemy. God wanted a small number to show himself. Hallelujah. Sometimes we ignore what God can do. When God does something, sometimes we want to brag about ourselves. This is what we can do. But in all things, we have to give glory to God. Like what Mama Pastor says, we have just to say thank to God in every situation. It makes God feel that the people, they honor me. God, Gideon went with the remaining people. God gave again another strategy. While they will be drinking water, the one that will lap water, those ones you are going to consider for the fight. The one that will drink water, those ones, they are not the people that are going to fight. Now he remained with few people. And the Bible says they attacked the enemy. And God spoke to Gideon, "You are going now, when you reach at the point of attacking the enemy, you're gonna blow your trumpet, and himself, God, is going to show his glory. Today we want to blow the trumpet. Trumpet of victory. Trumpet of breakthrough. Trumpet of pushing the enemy away from our crops. They blew the trumpet, and God caused themselves to start fighting between themselves, and the victory came back to Israel. They suffered for 7 years. The enemy came and destroyed everything for them, but God took Israel from nobody to become somebody. God made Gideon from nobody to become somebody. When God give you that promotion, he will change the situation of your life. The situation of your life will never be the same. God always takes somebody, someone from nobody to become a somebody. Remember what he did with David. God took David from keeping the sheep to the royal kingdom. Hallelujah. It's not all about neglecting yourself. I'm here to challenge you that you represent a great woman and man of God today. Everything that the devil is trying to destroy on your life, today's message is about to give you the courage. Today's message is about to give you the authority to push the devil, to push the enemy far away from your happiness, far away from your economy, far away from your family, far away from your business. We're gonna push. We're gonna pray until something happens. Are you ready to pray with me? Today we want to pray as we never done before. Today we want to push. We want to pray until something happens. I want you to, the way you came, don't go just the same way you came. I would like you to experience something from God. I would like you to go with a joy on our hearts. I want you to go back with a great testimony into your life. Or like Olaf and Ranil, when they go back, they will bring something in Pakistan. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know the kingdom of the devil has already started shaking there. And the way church right now, we are the people that are shaking the kingdom of the darkness. We are shaking the work of the devil around the world.
That's right.
It's up to you and me to stay on track. Don't be a victim of the devil. It is not time, my friend. It is time to push. Whenever you go home, push,
yes.
Which means pray until something happens.
Yes.
We are people. We are people who can partake the blessings of God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Gideon neglected himself. But God told him, stand up, you great mighty warrior. God is with you. And today I'm telling you, God is with you. Let's stand up on our feet, please, church. I would like us to pray until something happens. What is it that the devil has taken away from you? What is it that the devil is destroying during your lifetime? What is that you have planted? The devil is destroying all the time. You want to reap your blessings. We want to see when we are planting, we can harvest. Hallelujah. We want to see when we are planting, we are harvesting. If you don't harvest, there's something wrong. The enemy is coming to destroy what you have planted. Today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What are we going to do? Do this. Push. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Pray until something happens.
Yes.
Pray until
something happens.
Pray until
something happens.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you ready to stand up with me?
Sure.